Communication is the transmission of data from one computer to another, one place to another, or from one device to another. A communication device, therefore, is any machine that assists data transmission, for example, radio, television, satellites, etc., are all communication devices. Radio. A radio receiver is, in its simplest form, comprises of an input circuit for tuning into the frequencies of the various transmitters to be received, a demodulation circuit for separating audio frequencies from the high frequency carrier waves, a low frequency amplifier stage, and a loudspeaker. The amplifier elements, transistors, are supplied with the necessary operations voltage by a suitable device corresponding to the frequency bands on which the various transmitters operate. Receivers are occupied to receiving long waves, medium waves up to 16 kHz short waves, and the ultra short waves up to 100 mHz long, medium, and short wave reception function with the channel spacing of 9 kHz and with amplitude modulation AM. The channel spacing in the ultra short wave range is 300 kHz, and in this range frequency modulation is employed. Reception here is usually better than in the other ranges because high audio frequencies, which considerably affect the sound pattern, can also be transmitted. Besides, atmospheric disturbances, which have an amplitude modulating effect, are of hardly any significance to this kind of reception. The propagation conditions of the four radio waves ranges determines their possibilities of application and the purposes for which they are used. Long and medium wave transmitters send out a direct wave which travels along the Earth's surface, and an indirect wave in general. Only the direct wave is received, which has a range of up to some hundreds of miles. The indirect waves, which is reflected back from the heaviside layer and electricity conducting layer about 55 to 85 miles above the Earth's surface, makes such longer ranges possible. In the short waves range, only indirect waves are used. Ultra short waves are propagated in a quasi-optical manner. Waves travel in straight paths so that they cannot travel beyond the optical horizon. To extend the range as much as possible, the transmitting at an antenna is installed at the top of the high mast of building. Television is the world's most powerful form of communication. Every day it reaches out to millions of people to entertain and inform them with the real life images of the world around them. Television is a system of sending and receiving pictures and sound by means of electric signals transmitted through wires and optical fibers, or by electromagnetic radiation. These signals are usually broadcast from a central television station to reception devices in television sets in homes, or to relay stations used by cable television providers. The most common use of television is as the source of information and entertainment for viewers in their homes. Security personnel also use television to monitor buildings and facilities. Doctors can probe the interior of a human body with a microscopic television camera without conducting major surgery on the patient. Educators also use television to reach students throughout the world. The high frequency waves radiated by the transmitting antennas can travel only the straight line and may be blocked by obstacles. For this reason, transmitting antennas must be placed on tall buildings or towers. Cable television was first developed in the late 1940s to serve areas that were blocked from receiving signals. The signal is picked up on a receiver and distributed to cable viewers in most areas can now subscribe to cable television services that provides a wide variety of television programs and films transmitted by cable to the viewers. Television set networks, television stations use microwave relay stations to broadcast to affiliates far from original source of broadcast communication. Satellite also receive television signals from a ground station and relay them back to specified areas. Satellite transmissions are used to efficiently distribute television and radio programs from the one geographic location to another. In addition, direct broadcast satellite deliver television programming directly to individual receivers through small home dishes and microwave system. Microwave transmission consists of highly frequently wave that travel in straight lines through the air rather than through wires. A microwave system consists of towers located at intervals of 25 to 30 miles on which dish-like antennas are mounted, because from one another with the lower tower receives the signal. It amplifies the signal and sends it to the next tower. Communications satellites in space orbiting in the Clark orbit are also used as microwave relay stations because they rotate at the preset point and the speed above the equator and makes them appear stationary to the microwave transmitters on the ground. Microwave system have the capacity to carry large quantities of data, both digital and analog, at high rates of speed. They are used for the transmission of television and telephonic signals. Communication satellites. Satellites have now become an integral part of the worldwide communication system, although long-range and long-distance communications took place before the introduction of satellite systems. They had a lot of disadvantages. Point-to-point communication systems are very difficult in the case of remote and isolation locations. Locations which are surrounded by oceans, mountains and other obstacles created by nature. The satellite is nothing more than a radio relay station, but they have one potential advantage: the capability of the direct line of sight path to 98%, excluding the polar caps, which are inaccessible to satellite of the Earth's surface. And one of the most important events in the history of satellite communications took place when ComSat, or Communications Satellite Corporation, launched four satellites with 6 years, that is between 1965 to 1979. The first of these series was the Early Bird, which was launched in 1965. It was the first communication satellite to handle worldwide commercial telephone traffic from a fixed position in space. The next series, Intelsat, was a group of satellites that served 150 stations in 80 countries. The communication satellites are placed in orbits called equatorial and geosynchronous orbit. The satellite place in this orbit will appear stationary over a selected location on the Earth's surface. So communication satellites are placed in an orbit that is directly over the equator, moving in a web to east direction at an altitude of 22 to 282 miles above sea level and with a forward velocity of 6874 nph to complete one orbit in 24 hours. This orbit is called the Clerk orbit. All of the ground equipments along with the transmission and path and receiving antenna at the satellite and included the in uplink system. Basically this includes discriminated satellite transmit output power, downlink antenna again, and beam and Clerk orbit on satellite, good command to footprint area of 42.2% of the Earth's surface. The beam width from the satellite for such coverage is 17.2 degrees satellite. These three satellites are placed 120 degrees apart in the Clerk orbit and would cover the Earth's entire surface except for the polar caps. This makes it possible for one Earth station to transmit with its transmitted to its closest neighbors in the Clerk's orbit and from there back to the Earth. The close link distance in 45 to 458 miles between the satellite, making the total Earth satellite Earth distance